Hi there. Do come in. Just me, myself, and I in here. Just a typical Friday night, drinking by myself. Oh, that's bad wine. I've got my shelf out today because I'm having a little sort through, because at my local tube, they've got one of those really cool book swap library things where you give away books for free and then you take whatever you want. I walk past it every day. It's been there for months now. I've never actually swapped any books, so I'm going to get out all of the books that I didn't like, but you might, and therefore someone at the book swap might like them. I'm not giving away anything that I just think is total shit. Actually, I kind of am. So let's see what I've got. Sophie Hannah, A Game for All the Family. Now this one, it's not that I didn't like it, that's not quite fair. I actually really enjoyed this one. All through the book it sets up just a lot of strange characters and like creepy situations, which I loved, but you kind of want them to be resolved. This kind of felt like watching all six seasons or however many they were of Lost and then getting to that finale and being like, oh really? Probably wouldn't read it again, probably wouldn't give it to anyone. Well, I am giving it to the library, but it's a really fun book, so I'm hoping that somebody will enjoy this one. Next up is Maestra by L.S. Hilton. Now, I'm kind of sad to give this one away, if only because this cover is amazing. It's got like a real slash down there. I know that it looks like I'm stroking your vagina, I think that's deliberate. But sadly, I just got bored, which is really saying something in a book that's about sex and murder and the scandal in the art world. The reason that I didn't like it is because I didn't find the main character relatable. I like characters that are kind of a little bit psychopathic, that you can't quite get into their head, but I feel like you need to be given something that's slightly dangerous, like, oh, maybe I could do these things if I was in that situation too. Whereas with her, I just didn't get it. I didn't understand what was motivating her at all, but that's just me, and I did really feel when I finished it that some people might really enjoy this. This is the first of three. I'm not going to read the next ones. I Am Pilgrim. Now, it's kind of unfair of me to say that I didn't like this one because I didn't actually give it a shot. I tried maybe the first few pages before I gave up, but it's just because I am so squeamish, and this opens up with a pretty gruesome scene. I asked my friend who'd read it, she said that if you've got a squeamish stomach, it might not be for you, so I gave up on this one. But that same friend absolutely loved it herself, said it was amazing, so I'm sure that somebody is going to really enjoy this one. I can't tell you what it's about because I don't know. The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde, if that's how you pronounce that, I'm not entirely sure. You know, I feel like a bit of a failure for not enjoying this book. I'm mainly reading books by female authors at the moment, and mainly books about women, which I'm just really, really enjoying. So reading this male-written, male-driven book, I think maybe it was just the wrong time of my life to be reading it, so maybe I'll swap this one for a female-driven story. Now this one, someone is going to love. 50 Shades of Mr. Darcy. Written by William Codpiece Thwackery. You can't go wrong with that. This is their reinterpretation. It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good riding whip must be in want of a pair of pale, bare, female buttocks to thrash. I got it in a Christmas book swap and I thought it was funny, but I'm not actually going to sit down and read the whole thing. It does look so much fun and I hope that someone will really enjoy it. And finally, we have Lena Dunham's Not That Kind of Girl. As you can see, I put so many post-it notes. The green ones are bits that I liked, and the red ones are bits that made me really angry because they were really problematic. I knew going in that I was going to have mixed feelings about it because I have mixed feelings about most of what Lena Dunham says. I get annoyed about how much criticism she gets because I get annoyed about how much criticism women get generally, and therefore I actually really like Lena Dunham's confidence in speaking out about believing in herself and believing that her voice is valid and worth hearing. But I'm not going to turn to this book as a feminist manifesto because her feminism just is not inclusive enough. It does not include disabled women, women of different class to her, women of colour. I'm sure that she was being jokey with this title, Not That Kind of Girl, but the way that she refuses to include any women that aren't like her in her feminism kind of made that title a bit apt in a negative way. So I did think this book was really problematic. But yeah, she's a good writer, there's no doubt that she's talented. It is a funny read, it's an easy read, it's enjoyable. I kind of don't want to take the post-it notes out because I really like them. So maybe I'll leave them in. Someone might find that useful, they might find it annoying, I don't really know. So that's what I'm going to be doing tomorrow, going to the book swap, dropping off all of these and seeing what I can get in return. So I'm on my way to the book swap. I'm hoping there's going to be something good, otherwise I'd be a little sad giving away all of my books. The book swap was actually really good. I had no idea what to expect at all. I think that a lot of it had been donated by the same person because it was kind of overrun with Stephen King books, and I didn't want any of those. But with a bit of digging, I unearthed some pretty cool looking stuff. Who is Tom Ditto by Danny Wallace? The cover just instantly drew me in. It's so gorgeous. I love those colours. And I haven't really read much Danny Wallace, but I liked how intriguing the description of this one is. It doesn't give you much information at all, other than it's about someone called Tom Ditto, his girlfriend, who we don't really know who she is, who leaves him a note saying that she hasn't left him, but she's gone. What does that mean? I love really intriguing books like that where I don't know what to expect, so I'm looking forward to trying this one. Now, Junk by Melvin Burgess. I have heard of this one. This is a children's book that was very controversial when it came out because it's about drugs. And I love how colourful it is. And I like reading children's books sometimes, especially when it's seeing how a children's book tackles issues like drugs, so I'm intrigued by this one. And then finally, I got The Junior Officers Reading Club by Patrick Hennessy, a memoir of Patrick Hennessy's time fighting in Iraq and Afghanistan. From what I've read about it, it sounds really intense and moving, and it's about someone from his generation who grew up on video games and Hollywood movies, and then how he, as a young man, transferred that into his experience when he went to war. I thought that would be really interesting, maybe a bit of a tearjerker. Overall, I'd say that was a success. Thanks for drinking with me and my shelf. See you next time.